Yeah, I now request Professor Gadhi to come on stage. Professor Gadhi, till recently, was a professor at Kohler School of Management, Tel Aviv. He headed the Max Perlman Center for Global Business and was founding academic director of the Business Consulting Specialization in the MBA program. He did his undergraduate master's education in Tel Aviv University and obtained his PhD from the Wharton School. He has vast global experience in the area of innovation and entrepreneurship. And we are very proud that he is closely associated with this center already. And we hope that he will be with us for long in strengthening the relationship even further. With that, hand over to Gadhi to address us.
Thank you very much, Abhoy. Esteemed guest, our understanding of global business strategy is recognized in recent years that in spite of the fact that we've been very euphoric about globalization, we have underestimated the significance of distance. And even in a sort of flat world, distance apparently matters. And the IIM Bangalore Israel Center is born into this Indian-Israeli paradoxical and challenging space of rapidly shortening geographic distance and long and frustratingly slowly closing business culture distance. That has to be addressed. Paradoxical in the sense that, and everybody who gets to speak about India-Israel relationship notice the sort of the huge potential. And on the other side, the sort of the largely unfulfilled, or if I want to be graceful, very slow to materialize potential. Challenging in the sense that the Israeli-Indian corridor is not a tabula rasa. It's not a clean table, but has been burdened with some noisy, ill-thought-out ventures that eventually and rightfully failed. The succumbing to human nature, the entrepreneurs who led these ventures were looking at the mirror when succeeding and looked at the window when they failed. Being Israelis, and Ajay has pointed out our directness and the quickness of response, Israelis have been quick to blame the Indian window rather than to acknowledge what they've seen or actually have not seen in the Israeli mirror. My knowledge of Indian business people, I would assume that the same sentiment exists on the Indian side, given the Indian sort of respect, okay, and sort of a deference in that sense. We have not heard it. In small circles, intimate discussions, you can find that the frustration is mutual. And again, you have to recognize the problem. If you don't recognize the problem, there's no hope of solving it. So my conclusion is that in the current situation, what is urgently called for is unhurried thoughtfulness. And in this is the sweet spot, I think, of the Israel Center, created in the premier locus of Indian business scholarship. I am Bangalore, my home away from home, for almost 4 years now. And so I want to make a point about scholarship. Scholarship, scholar, comes from the Greek word schola. And schola means, people are surprised to find out that schola means leisure, time, free time. Scholarship doesn't exist if it's not given the proper space and time spent. This is perhaps the ultimate role of the center, and in the clearest definition of its sort of mission. Its role is to add to the busy Indian-Israeli business corridor a reflective dimension, a slow dimension, if you will, an opportunity not only to do, but also to observe, learn, reflect, inform, actually teach. While keeping loyalty to the academic and the scholarly mission, the center undoubtedly will serve very well the business communities on both sides, because the mutual knowledge is urgently needed, and the computing sort of India and Israel, and help them to not destroy so much business value as they have been doing in the past. In the grander scheme, and I relate to my ambassador, Carmon, It will serve the intensifying and actually so natural and so warm relationship between India and Israel, both vibrant national communities of ancient civilization. So, final thank you, Abhoy, for letting me speak today, as there is no one more fortunate in this room and more happier in the room to see this coming to life, and recognizing the contribution of the Professor Raghuram, who sort of took the plunge, and there's always the last one who have to take the plunge to make it happen. It's sort of made in the making for a while, but someone has to sort of switch on the shelter, and you've done the switch, you've done it. Again, recognizing the entrepreneurship doesn't happen without championship. And Abhoy has been sort of a natural soulmate and champion on the other side, which allowed it to happen. And last but not least, the sort of surprisingly wide circle of IMB faculty members who are committed to the pursuit of Israeli studies and Israel relationship. And I'm always surprised to find more and more people that I meet in the corridors that are actually interested in doing in Israel. So I think the center is, the starting point is extremely solid. And so even though it's just started, it'll hit the ground running, as we say in Americanism. So thank you for everyone for coming. Thank you for letting me speak here. And I wish all of us huge success in the future.
Thank you. We look forward to your continued support for the center and other initiatives. Before closing, I wish to acknowledge the support of Dana Kirsch, Consul General of Israel, and her office in putting this event together. And I look forward to similar support for our future initiatives. I also wish to thank our CAO and his office, and Kavita Kumar and our communication groups, and many more behind the scene for their assistance. That concludes the formal proceedings for this event. I thank all the dignitaries and invitees who have attended this event. Thank you for coming.